Hi, my name is Mohak Chadha. I'm a third year PhD student at the Chair of Computer Architecture and Power Systems at the Technical University of Munich. This is my WSC 2022 presentation on the topic Migrating from Microservices to Serverless and IoT Platform Case Study. The presentation is structured as follows. First, I will talk about the motivation behind the work, followed by the goals of the work, then some background information, followed by a migration methodology, experimental setup, results, and finally, conclusion and future work. Most cloud native applications today are based on the microservices architecture. This type of architecture enables the development of an application as a suite of small independent services communicating with each other. It has several advantages. First, the application is decomposed into a set of manageable services, which are faster to develop and easier to understand. Second, each service can be developed independently by a team that is focused particularly on that service. Third, a particular service is not bounded to a set of technologies. Finally, each service can be deployed and scaled independently. Also, it has several disadvantages. First, testing a microservices-based application is more difficult. Second, the developer needs to think about the configuration, deployment, resource provisioning, and scaling of the individual services. Another competing cloud computing paradigm is serverless computing, aka function as a service, in which users are only responsible for writing small pieces of code, while all infrastructure management is handled by the cloud service provider. So essentially like a black box. In FaaS, developers deploy their functions on the FaaS platform and obtain an API endpoint through which the function can be invoked. Traditionally, functions are more fine granular than independent microservices. Moreover, most FaaS platforms follow a more fine-grained and pay-per-use billing policy. FaaS traditionally has better resource utilization with scaling to zero for idle function instances. However, in FaaS, functions are stateless, and there are significant performance variations in FaaS due to cold starts. Both microservices and serverless architectures have their advantages and disadvantages, and decision to adopt one over the other depends on several factors. To try and answer that question, in this work, we migrate a microservices-based IoT platform application onto Apache OpenRisk and GCR. We evaluate the different deployment strategies with respect to performance metrics. And finally, we highlight some lessons learned from this work. The IoT platform application was designed by us to enable numerous IoT applications such as room monitoring. It consists of several independent microservices that interact with each other to provide different functionalities. The main component is the IoT core backend and frontend, which allows users to manage devices, sensors, and authentication and authorization tokens for secure communication with the end devices. All data related to users, devices, sensors, and consumers is stored in MariaDB. The devices can send sensor data using the three different gateways. The received data is then forwarded to Kafka, which is then finally indexed in Elasticsearch via Kafka Connect. The stored sensor data can also be visualized using Kibana. The IoT platform provides several API endpoints that enable users and consumers to interact with the platform and perform CRUD operations. In this work, we only focus on the mentioned six API endpoints. To minimize code changes, we do not migrate the different off-the-shelf software components. We only focus on adapting and migrating the IoT backend component and the HTTP gateway. We completely decompose the different API endpoints in the backend onto OpenRisk and GCR, but only focus on the six mentioned endpoints. The main methodology behind our migration was that we decomposed the application logic for each specific API endpoint into a separate function. For instance, the different functionalities provided by the device controller were migrated onto separate individual functions. Also, we made use of action sequencing in OpenRisk to chain the authentication function with the different API endpoints. For GCR, the authentication functionality was merged into the individual middleware functions. To generalize this migration process a bit, so all state that is stored in a service must be converted to an external data stored in FAS. Moreover, we need to change the communication protocols to work with the particular FAS platform. For instance, converting Thrift RPC to gRPC for GCR. Implementation of an abstract interface that intercepts an incoming request to an API endpoint and forwards it to the appropriate OpenVSC or GCR function, which essentially is the interconnect interface implemented in the IoT core backend. So moving on to our experiment setup. So all of the off-the-shelf services were hosted on a separate GKE cluster for fairness. For our experiments, we considered four deployment strategies: Google Kubernetes Engine. For GKE, we considered two configurations for the horizontal pod autoscaler: 50% CPU utilization and 80% CPU utilization. We deployed OpenVSC on top of GKE, and finally, the managed Google Cloud Run service. For exact configurations, please look in the paper. For load testing the different deployment strategies, we used the regression testing tool K6 by Grafana Labs. K6 utilizes virtual users, which are essentially entities that make HTTP requests and try to perform a given test as often as possible. For our experiments, we use a VM hosted on our institute's compute cloud. We consider three different workload patterns: linear, random, and spike. The test duration is 30 minutes each. So we ran a total of 72 experiments, and the total number of requests were in the eight figures. The top two figures show the number of requests, while the bottom two show the P95 response time for our different deployment strategies. For most API endpoints, we observed the GKE deployment strategies performed best, followed by GCR and then OpenVSC. We had a significant increase in the P95 response time for OpenVSC for greater than 2000 requests per 10 seconds. Moreover, the initial response times for GCR were significantly high as well due to cold starts. In contrast to the CensusGet API endpoint, for the HTTP gateway, the serverless deployments perform better than GKE. The OpenVSC deployment performs significantly better. The main reason for this was the high initial resource provisioning for OpenVSC in our experiment configuration. Moreover, while GCR limits the amount of CPU resources allocated to a function, with OpenVSC, no such limit is enforced, leading to better performance. So the main takeaways from our performance analysis are, we observed that GKE setups perform best with the highest performance, followed by GCR and then OpenVSC. For the different load patterns, we observed marginal differences. OpenVSC was significantly bad, the performance, for more than 2000 requests per second. Also, GKE 50 performed slightly better than GKE 80. GCR overall was more robust than OpenVSC, primarily because it is a managed service. We also compared the cost for different API endpoints for our different deployment strategies. From our experiments, we observed that per 1,000 requests, GCR was always cheaper. To summarize, the main takeaways are, so migrating a microservices application is mostly ad hoc and application dependent. So before starting the migration process, the developer should consider the amount of code that can be reused. On traffic bursts, response times in GCR can significantly increase. GKE standard has the best performance, although higher cost. And the amount of decomposition is also important. From our experiments, we observed that migrating deeply nested microservices applications into individual fast functions can lead to worse performance and more cost. In the future, we plan to experiment with GKE Autopilot, play with different fast configurations, such as setting the concurrent number of requests that can be handled by a function instance and setting the minimum number of instances. And we are looking into migrating bigger microservices applications. Thank you.